Let us say you have 40 rupees and you were in need of money. So, you ask your friend for some money and say he gives you 30 rupees. So, you would have a total of 40 plus 30 rupees. Now, let's change the situation a bit. Let's say you had 30 rupees and your friend gives you 40. So, you would have now 30 plus 40. So, in both the situations, you get here 30 plus 40, which is 70, and 40 plus 30, again 70. So, you see that in both these situations, you get the same amount. So, I can say that 30 plus 40 is same as 40 plus 30. Order does not matter. Whether you add 40 to 30 or 30 to 40, the value does not change. And hence, I can say that addition is commutative. Why commutative? Commute means that you can move to and fro about a point. Now, you can exchange 30 and 40 about this symbol of addition. I can exchange the places without the value being changed, and hence I can say that addition is commutative. Now, what about subtraction? Let's say you had 40 rupees and now your friend is in need and he asks you for 30 rupees. So, you'll have to give him 30 rupees. If you give your friend 30 rupees, you would be left with 40 minus 30. That is 10 rupees. What if you had just 30 and your friend had asked for 40 rupees? So, even if you give him your 30 rupees, you would have to give him 10 more. So, in this case, you had 30, your friend asked for 40, so you actually owe him 10 more rupees. So, we say that here, you actually owe him 10 more rupees, whereas in this situation, you were left with 10 rupees. So, both these situations are not the same. They are not equal, and hence I can say that subtraction is not commutative, because I cannot reverse the order. I cannot say that 30 minus 40 is same as 40 minus 30. It's not the same, and hence subtraction is not commutative. We have seen that 30 minus 40 is not equal to 40 minus 30. But I know that subtraction of a positive number is same as adding a negative number. Subtracting a positive is same as adding a negative. So rather than writing minus 30 minus 40, I change it to adding a negative plus, and I change this positive number to negative, that is plus minus 40. So I get 30 plus negative 40. So this is what I get. Now I know that addition is commutative. So about this symbol, now I can exchange these two positions because addition is commutative. So I can say that 30 plus negative 40 would be same as, change these two, negative 40 plus 30. So we see that subtraction is not commutative, but if you change subtraction to addition, if you make this subtracting a positive, if you convert it to adding a negative, and then you can apply commutative because addition is commutative. Then you can reverse the order because addition is commutative. Now let us look at this. Say you had 40 rupees, again, you were in need of money, so you go to your friends and ask for money. One of your friends gives you 30 rupees, so you would have a total of 40 plus 30. Now let's say that another friend of yours gives you 50 rupees. So you had 40 plus 30 plus 50 more. If I change this situation a bit, let's say you had 40 rupees, again you go to your friends and ask for money. What your friends decide is, they get together, pool in money and give you that amount. So both your friends get together, they add 50 plus 30 and they give you that amount, which is 30 plus 50. So you had 40 and you got 30 plus 50 more. In both these situations, 40 plus 30 is 70, 70 plus 50 would be 120. What about this? 30 plus 50 is 80 and 40 plus 80 is 120 again. So in both these situations you see that you get the same amount. This is equal to this. The value is not changing. So I can say both of them are equal. Order in which you group them or order in which you associate them does not matter. And hence I can say that addition is associative. Either you group the first two, either you associate the first two or the last two. The order in which you take the numbers does not matter and hence addition is associative. Now would subtraction be associative? Let us see. Let's say now if subtraction is associative, then I can group the first two terms or the last two terms, it would not change the answer. That means if grouping the first two terms, I get this. This should be equal to grouping the last two terms. So I get 5 minus I group the last two terms. If subtraction is associative, then this should be equal to this. Whether I group the first two or I group the last two, it should not change the value. Let us solve this. 5 minus 3 is 2. And 2 minus 2 gives me 0. What about this? 3 minus 2, which is 1. And 5 minus 1 gives me? So 0 and 4 here. Both these sides are not equal. And hence I can say that subtraction is not associative. So we've seen addition is commutative, addition is associative too. Subtraction is not commutative and subtraction is not associative also. Now from addition, if I keep adding things, the same thing again and again, repeated addition gives me multiplication. So now let's see whether multiplication is commutative and associative. So let me add 2 3 times. So I have these two blocks. I add these two blocks 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So I add these two blocks 3 times. Now let's look at 3 added 2 times. So I start with 3 blocks and I add this 2 times. 1 and 2. So now if I stack these blocks together, if I stack this together and this together, what do I get? Either if I stack this, I'll get this. If I stack these two columns together, again I would get this same box. So we see that whether you add 2 3 times or 3 2 times, you get the same thing. I can say 2 added 3 times as 2 into 3 and 3 added 2 times as 3 into 2. So this block represents, you can say, either 2 into 3 or 3 into 2 because both of them are the same thing. I can say that 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2. Now what do you see? That about this multiplication sign, you can change the order of the 2 without changing the value. And hence I can say that multiplication is commutative. You can commute, these two numbers can commute to and fro about this multiplication sign. And so I can say that multiplication is commutative. Now let's see whether multiplication is associative. So is multiplication associative? That's my next question. Let's see. Let's start with 2 into 3. I had two blocks added 3 times, we've just seen. So we get 2 into 3. Now let me add this block. So I get another block 2 times, 3 times, 4 times. So I add 2 into 3 is added 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. This block is added 4 times. So what do I get? 2 into 3 into 4. Now, if I stack this together, I would get this block. If I put all of this together, I would get this block. And this block signifies 2 into 3 into 4. 2 into 3 into 4. Now, if I look at this block, this is this block, 3 blocks added 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 3 into 4, 3 blocks added 4 times. Now, if I add another such block, so I have 3 into 4, 3 into 4. So, 3 into 4 added 2 times. I can say this is equal to 3 into 4 into 2. Since multiplication we know is commutative, the order can be changed without changing the value. So, I can see that 3 into 4 into 2 is equal to 2 into 3 into 4. I swap the positions of these two numbers. So, this is true. Now, if I stack this block together, what will I get? This block, which again signifies 2 into 3 into 4. So, we see that in the first situation, this block is signifying 2 into 3 into 4. In the second situation, the same block signifies 2 into 3 into 4. So, the order in which you are associating or grouping, either the first two or the last two, the value is not changing. You're getting the same block. The value is not changing, and hence I can say that multiplication is associative. Associative, you can associate or group any two, and hence it is associative. So, we have seen that addition is commutative, addition is associative too. Now, from addition, repeated addition gives me multiplication, and multiplication too is both associative and commutative.